Seymour Micro Panel can be set up to generate several kinds of alarm signals. Beeps, blinking screen colors, blinking LEDs down here on the function keys, and even flashing banner messages across the top of the screen, all in response to your alarms. Let's see how to set these up. You configure alarms in the Alarm Control Setup dialog under the Navigation Windows Function tab, Alarm Control Setup, or under the Setup menu, Alarm Control Setup. Select the tag that you want to assign alarm conditions to. Let's grab this pressure tag. And because the pressure tag is a numeric type, we need to enter some value when the error occurs. Let's say this one is an alarm when the pressure is greater than 150 psi. Now, what do I want it to do when that happens? Let's have that alarm condition fire off some beeps and toggle the backlight color between, let's say, yellow and how about red. For the temperature tag, let's have this one generate an alarm when the temperature goes above 200 degrees. And when it does alarm, let's have it just generate a banner message. How about too hot? And let's do one more. Let's grab this fault tag, which is a discrete type. So now we have to tell it it's an alarm when it's in the on or the off state. Let's make this one alarm when it's on. And when that does happen, let's do everything. We're gonna beep, we're gonna blink LED, let's say F5 in this example. We're gonna toggle the backlight between yellow and amber. And we'll put out a banner message across the top of the screen. It says system fault. Once you have all your alarm conditions defined the way you want them, hit OK. We're not going to add any buttons here. We'll just manually force the alarms for this example. So let's go straight to the simulator, save the project, and up pops our alarms demo. Again, we have no controls here, so we'll just come over to our control window and force these alarms. So let's see, when the pressure went above 150 psi, we're supposed to get an alarm. So let's make it 151. And sure enough, we get our blinking screens and our beeps. By the way, pressing a function key silences the beeps, but the alarms don't go away until the fault condition is taken care of. We're also supposed to get alarms when temperature goes over 200, so I'll put in 201. And in this case, we get our simple banner message, left justified, flashing across the top of the screen. And that'll stay there until the alarm condition goes away. And there we go. Finally, our fault condition. When the Seymour Micro sees this tag switch to on, all four things happen. We get beeps, flashing LEDs, blinking screen colors, and the message across the top of the screen. Again, pressing any function key will silence the alarms, but the alarm condition is still there until this fault goes away. One final note on alarm priority. Let's go back to our alarm setup screen and take a look at this. If multiple alarms are active at the same time, the highest priority alarm will be issued. The alarms are shown in this dialog in priority order. You can see this is the highest priority alarm, this is the next priority, this is the next priority. You're allowed to set up 16 alarms, and the top one in this list will be your highest priority alarm. If all three of these fired off at the same time, you would get these alarms until that condition went away. Then you would get these alarms until that condition went away. And finally, you would get these alarms until that condition went away. Suppose we want the fault to be the highest priority alarm. We simply click on the fault and push the up button to push it to the top of the list. So using up and down, you can move alarms around on that priority list. Note that you can also quickly change conditions without having to go back into each individual one. You can just turn them on and off right here within the dialog. Well, that's all there is to setting up alarms. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.